going to use to vanilla cupcakes is creaming method. Now this method is very very important. Okay, so most of the cakes which you will find outside are based on this method, creaming method. So it has a very basic thing that you start with your fat, then your sugar goes inside it, then your eggs, then your flour. This is a basic, you know, this thing, pattern which is followed in your creaming of your cakes. Okay, even for the creaming of the cookies also the same basic pattern is used. So today we're going to learn the basic method, that is your creaming method.
Ingredients used are refined flour, powdered sugar, margarine, eggs, baking powder, vanilla essence, and water. The first thing what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to put the duster like this, folded, and damp duster so that the vessel doesn't move. It gives a nice grip to your vessel. You can use a glass vessel or a steel vessel. I'm going to put margarine inside it and soften it up. Okay. Move it in the circular motion and try to soften it up. I'm going to hold it with a finger like this so that it gives a nice grip to your wooden spoon, and keep on mixing it nicely like this. Okay, soften it up. It's not compulsory to use margarine. You can also use your butter. Okay, unsalted butter is preferable. Okay, only in that case you have to make sure you put less water inside it. In the end we're going to add water, that you have to put less. Then I'm going to put your powder sugar inside it. I'm going to divide the powder sugar in two or three parts, it depends on you. I'm going to first make sure the margarine and powder sugar is nicely mixed together. Okay, grain sugar is not suggested to be used over here because you will not get a nice cream texture out of it. Then you tilt the bowl like this and you start creaming it. If the initial stage only you, when you put the powder sugar, you cream the, when you tilt the bowl, there are a lot of chances that the sugar will come out. Okay, so I'll just cream this properly. And the whole idea behind the creaming is that I want to incorporate air inside it. Scrape the bowl, whatever is there on the sides, remove it and put it in the basin. At regular intervals keep on doing that, remove it, put it in the base. Then I'm going to put the second part of sugar. I have removed the middle part in which I was creaming it for a lot of time actually over here. I'm again going to start creaming it nicely. This process is a pretty long process. Now in this video it is not so much visible because I have deleted some of it, because I'm continuously just mixing it. Again I'm going to do the same thing. Once the sugar is mixed properly, I'm going to tilt it, okay, and I'm going to start creaming it nicely. Okay, in case of your margarine it is a little hard, whereas in case of your butter it's very very soft. Keep on creaming it like this. The creaming will be done will be faster in case of your butter. Okay, the same thing I have done over here. Again I have creamed everything which is I have removed everything which is there on the sides and put that in the base. Okay, now I'm putting my last part of my sugar inside it. There is no hard and fast rule that how many parts it has to go in. It all depends on you. It just makes this easier for us to cream it, otherwise it becomes very difficult for you to cream. It becomes too hard for you to cream. If you see in the initial stage, it is hard. You can feel it, you know, with your fingers. But once you start creaming it, see, like this, you can feel it with your fingers. Okay, you will feel it lighter in the later part. You know, you can, after you start creaming it nicely. So it's very important. So initially you feel it with your fingers. You will feel a little heavy. And later again you feel it with the fingers and you'll feel that it is very light. Okay, the pressure what you're applying for the creaming also, that also will be reduced. Now I'm going to take eggs inside it. I'm going to break the eggs and put it in this measuring jug. Break two eggs and start beating it with the egg beater. All the ingredients which I am using over here are all sieved. Okay, so your powder sugar also was sieved nicely. You have to beat it till it is nice and fluffy. The egg has to be beaten till then. Now I'm going to put vanilla essence inside it, okay, and I am going to again keep on beating it. Now what happens over here is that your the margarine and the sugar is a fat based mixture, and your this thing, your egg is your water based mixture. We are trying to mix and make a emulsion. Okay, so if we over mix it, it is going to curdle. So it is very important that we don't over mix it, nor we want the gluten to be formed over here. So don't over mix it. Whatever ingredients I am going to use, I am going to make sure that I sieve the ingredients that I use. So first I am going to take 1/4 teaspoon of my baking powder, which I am going to put in my flour, very fine flour, which is also known as your maida, and I am going to sieve it. Okay, so sieve it with the sieve like this. This all can be done beforehand also, not necessary it has to be done in the last moment only. You can just keep everything ready and start mixing it together. Okay, but I just wanted to show it to you. That's the reason I am doing it to you in front of you right now. Now before you put the egg inside it, a very small rule is there that you put a small amount of your flour inside in your mixture. The whole idea behind putting this flour inside in the creamed mixture is so that the mixture will not curdle after you put eggs inside it. Okay, so just put little flour and just mix it. Then I'm going to put the eggs inside it, the beaten eggs, part by part. Always remember, whenever you put the eggs inside it, the eggs have to be beaten up. Okay, like now I'm going to put, immediately you beat it, okay, and then only you put it. Otherwise what happens, the water is, you know, settled down in the water base, and we don't want the water, sorry, the egg, the liquid part, the heavy part is settled down in the base and the foam stays on the top. We don't want that to happen. That's the reason, always beat it and then only you put it inside in the creamed mixture. The baking powder that I used in the flour is a chemical leavening agent which produces carbon dioxide gas. Okay, here again I am going to scrape your fat, the mixture which is there on the side. Always keep on doing this thing, okay, so that you get a homogeneous mixture over here. Scrape everything which is there on the sides, put that in the base and you start mixing that again properly. Mix it, do not over mix it. Again I'm telling you, do not over mix it. There are a lot of chances that the mixture will curdle if you over mix it. Beat the eggs and then only you put the eggs inside it. Do not put it just like that, otherwise the only froth or only liquid will come. So make sure you're beating the egg nicely and then only you're putting it inside it. And this is my last part of my egg. One of the reason that I don't put all the eggs together is again that I don't want the mixture to curdle, and that's the reason I'm not putting all the eggs together inside it. Be careful while mixing. With the help of a spatula, remove whatever is there on your wooden spoon. See, can you see the margarine and your sugar mixture is there on your wooden spoon? Okay, most of the time this is neglected and then in the end you get a fault in your cake. So we are going to make sure that all this is removed and mixed with the mixture properly. This point of time when you're going to put fat your flour inside it, I'm going to remove my wooden spoon out of it because I don't want to apply too much of pressure, you know. So I'm going to put all my flour along with my baking powder inside in the mixture over here. And I'm going to mix it with the help of spatula. The method is called as cut and fold. See, you go round, cut and you fold. Cut and you fold. Whatever flavor you want to put, like for example, this is a basic recipe. Now I'm putting here water for the consistency. I'm going to put about 4 tablespoons of water. But if you want, you can use same recipe for your strawberry cake or your orange cake. You know, you name them and you can make that recipe out of this. Okay. Do not overmix. Again, I'm telling you, lightly you cut and fold it. So where I had put water, you can use a crush. Okay, or you can use different essences also, and you mix it. If you mix it too much, it is going to become flat. If you mix it less, lumps are going to form. So it's very, very important that you mix as much as required over here. Okay, you have to mix it. How do you find out whether how much water has to go inside? A simple thing is the mixture should be of a dropping consistency. If the mixture is not of the dropping consistency, which means you can put little more water inside it. So I'm going to put this aside and I am going to line my tins. These are my patty tins. In this, I am going to line it with the cupcake liner. Now, these cupcake liners are for the tins. There are other ones also in which you don't require the patty tins. You can even use those also. Okay. Now, as I was telling you before, you can make different flavors. We can also make the same with the same recipe. You can make a chocolate flavor also. In that you will require for 115 grams of refined flour is there. In that case, you will require 15 grams of your cocoa powder and then 100 grams of refined flour. If you see, I have taken only that much in the spoon. For each tin, each patty, I'm going to put that much only. Okay, I'm going to divide it like that. See, this thing, I'm going to put it like that only. That much portion only. Okay, that is how you divide it into exactly 10 portion. Another way is to weigh it. Okay, to get equal and exact shape, but as I know from this recipe, I get around 10 of them, so I'm going to just divide equally in each cupcake mold. When you look at it, that time only you realize how much is required over here. Okay. I think this cupcake had more, so I removed from that and I put into a cupcake liner in which there was less batter. With my spoon only I am settling it down. I am not banging it or something, it will disfigure the cupcake liner. This will go for baking at 180 degrees Celsius for 15 to 20 minutes.